We continue our reading of Lest We Forget, a daily devotional by author George R. Knight. Today's reading is August the 4th, the end of an era. All flesh is like grass, and all its glory like the flower of grass. The grass withers, and the flower falls, but the word of the Lord endures forever. 1 Peter 1:24 and 25. Between 1872 and 1881, the Seventh-day Adventist Church would see two of its three founders laid to rest. The first was Joseph Bates, who died at the Health Reform Institute in Battle Creek on March 19, 1872, shortly before his 80th birthday. The old health reformer had kept a strong program going until near the end. The year before his death, he held at least 100 public meetings, besides those at his local church and the conferences that he attended. The aged warrior attended one of the last general conference sessions a year before his death. The annual meeting, he exuberantly reported, was one of deep, stirring interest to the cause. It was encouraging to hear what has been accomplished the past year and to learn of the wide openings for missionary work and the urgent and pressing calls for ministerial labor throughout the wide harvest field. Bates desperately desired to answer the call, but couldn't. He attended his last session 2 months before his passing, closing with a prayer. O Lord, in Jesus' dear name, help us with this dear people to fulfill our sacred promise, and may all thy remnant waiting people also enter into covenant with thee. Whereas Bates was in good health right up to the end, the same cannot be said of James White. Overwork had triggered a series of debilitating strokes beginning in the mid-1860s. Given his health condition, it is absolutely amazing how much he continued to accomplish. He would die 2 days after his 60th birthday on August 6, 1881. Ellen was shattered. I am fully of the opinion, she penned to her son Willie, that my life was so intertwined or interwoven with my husband's that it is about impossible for me to be of any great account without him. Letter 17, 1881. 16 years later, she wrote, how I miss him. How I long for his words of counsel and wisdom. How I long to hear his prayer blending with my prayer for light and guidance, for wisdom to know how to plan and lay out the work. Second Selected Messages, page 259. That's where the Advent hope comes in. Along with Ellen, we also await the greeting on that resurrection morning of not only her husband and Bates, but our own beloved ones. This concludes our reading today of Lest We Forget.